Sanity have just launched Functions. That is an event handler for every if this, then that scenario for your content operation. These event handlers are authored in code and deployed to our infrastructure so that anything that needs to happen when an author takes action on a document does happen. That might be invalidating a cache, embellishing a document with more information, running AI services against content, whatever you need to do. And Functions are authored in a new piece of configuration that we call blueprints. So you can't create a function without creating a blueprint. Let's start there. So in this particular setup, I've got my Sanity Studio on the right-hand side, and here I've got a mono repo setup. You can see I've got a few apps that I've been showing off recently. I've got my Sanity Studio here, and then I'm going to work at the root of this project. You could do everything I'm about to show from inside of a Sanity Studio project, but because blueprints are eventually going to represent everything in my Sanity infrastructure, I'm going to do this at the root. So let's close the file browser and open my terminal here, and a new blueprint can be invoked from the command line. It's as simple as npx sanity at latest blueprints. Init. And this will create the files that I need at the root of my directory. In particular, it's going to create two once I've selected a project. You can see here some errors about an existing blueprint because, as you imagine, I've run this demo a few times locally first. So it's created two new files. Let's have a look at those. In the .sanity folder, which is a hidden directory, we can see here my project ID as I've selected. This file is deliberately hidden and not designed to be checked into Git because we wanted to keep anything identifiable about the project hidden, and then our blueprints could be portable between multiple projects in a future where we're creating functions that are useful across multiple projects. And we also have our blueprint.json, which in future might be Sanity or sanityblueprint.json or TS or JS. And here we can see that it's empty at the moment. It has no resources. So this concept of resources means we need to fill this out. And the first resource that we can add is a function. So once again, let's close our file browser there. And I can say npx sanity at latest blueprints add function. So this is going to take us through the steps of adding a function. Let's call this one first published. I should have said what we were going to do with this function. We're going to create a function that will add the first published date to a document if it hasn't been added already. This is really useful when we're in an editorial scenario like a blog. I'm going to choose this one's going to be written in TypeScript, and you can see now that our blueprint file has been updated. We now have a resource here. This is a function. Here's the path of the files that have been created, easy AI, and this is the type of function that's going to be run. So on publish events, this function will fire. And as we can see, AI is being very eager here to add some extra filters because I've done this before. So here, I want to add a filter here. I don't want to run this on every single document. You may, with a function, want to run it on every single document in every single data set, but I actually only want to run it on post type documents where a first published field has not been defined. This is really important if your function is going to make changes to a document. You don't want to end up with a recursive function, because if you're not a paying member with Sanity, you'll be canned from using functions for the rest of the month. And if you are a paying member, it could lead to overages. So be very careful with the possibility of recursive functions. And that's when we're writing a function which can modify a document. I'm also going to add this projection here, which is going to grab the ID field off of the document. That's always going to exist. That's really great. If we wanted to get multiple fields, we could do that as well. And just because this video may change, double check the documentation, because there's a future where you might actually want to put curly braces around that too. So for now, we can just grab that ID field. And if we have a look at our file browser now, we can see I've got my Sanity directory, got the blueprint file, and now I've got this functions directory. And inside of here is my first published function, which at the moment just has your Sanity function was called at this time. And we can invoke this function locally now too. So let's go and run this command to run functions. And then we can say test first published. And we can see here now I've got the response of that function when it's been run. So you can see we have some tools available to us to test this function locally, which is excellent. And we could have passed along some data from right here in the command line, or we can reference a file that has some JSON within it so that that data is then available to our function during testing. I'm now going to make a huge change to this function file. If you want this code example, it's in the blog post you'll find linked in the description below. You can see I've updated this code snippet here to call in some TypeScript helpers from the Sanity Functions package and the client from Sanity Client. We'll need to install those packages within the function. You can install these packages to the root of your project, but because in my particular monorepo workspace at the moment, I don't have dependencies in the root, I'm just going to npm install those directly to the function. Now, if we go back to the root of the project, close the terminal again. You can see the event handler has this TypeScript helper here, where this is all of the data that we're passing along, again, because that came from our projection. And now we return the result of this client that we're creating, along with the context in which the function was run. This context will be full of configuration information in production. Locally, we could pass along some flags in the CLI, check the documentation for more details on how to populate this context locally. And now, if you're familiar with the Sanity client, you know we can run a patch operation using that ID that came along from the function. And now we run this set if missing patch to set the first published to the date and time that the function was run. And then we log out the results so that we can test this locally as well. And now this won't take any action if I press publish in the studio to the right-hand side. I'll have to deploy this blueprint first. And that's as simple as Sanity at latest, blueprints, deploy. You may see some small differences here because I have deployed this before. And now with that deployed, I can press publish in my studio. And nothing happened. Why is that? It's really simple, actually. I didn't press save on that function. And so what I actually just promoted to my blueprint was that log before I pressed save. I'm going to leave this error in here because it's a simple thing to get wrong, right? But we can now inspect the logs and think, well, why didn't anything happen? Let's see how there's some errors in our logs. That's probably a first good place to look. We can see what were the logs for the first published. And we'll probably get that hello from Sanity function. There we go. Hello from function. Here's the previous logs from my last recording of this video. And then here's the latest log from that function. My function was called at this particular time. So we can see I've saved this function now. So let's redeploy that again. What an embarrassing mistake to make in this video. And here you thought I knew what I was doing with Sanity. It's easy to make mistakes. But the great thing is, because this function was set to run only if this field was not filled, that field is still not filled. So let's just put in a space here to trigger that publish event again, and we should get that field filled out immediately. And we do. So there we go. There's a working function, and we can test those logs once again too. So let's have a look at the logs for our function here, and this should return exactly what we wanted to see. There we go. This is the document that got modified. And this is what it looks like after it has been patched. So there's a very simple example of creating a Sanity function and deploying it via a blueprint to write to a document when it's first published. We can do so many things now, defined as code and deployed to Sanity's infrastructure, which before took a lot more steps to get this going. So can't wait to see what you'll do with functions, and stay tuned for more.